And I'm talking with Ingmar Bergman and with B.B. Anderson. It's always said that Ingmar Bergman understands women. Would you say that's true?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's, there are directors who are famous for working with women, and for some reason they get along with the women better than they do with the men. Is it that way with you?
No.
No, it's not so. I think I like, because I'm a man, I like more to work with women, to talk with women, to be together with women, of course. Mm-hmm. I think it has nothing to do with that. I am passionately interested in human beings, in the human face, in the human soul. And if it's a man or a woman, it's indifferent. I don't mind. But to work with on the stage or in the studio is much more fascinating to me, because I think acting is a very special woman profession.
A woman, very special woman's profession.
Yes.
Yes.
Women have much more talent for acting. And I don't say it in a moral as a moral judgment or in a negative way, but it's not so difficult for them.
Why should that be? I've never heard anyone say that before.
I don't know. Perhaps it's very difficult to explain that, women are more open. They open up more. They are more fascinated wearing clothes or not wearing clothes, you know, to look in you know, the camera. Mm-hmm. Or the audience is a sort of a mirror. And I think women are more, perhaps from education, more used to enjoy this looking into that mirror, that is the audience or the camera's eye. Do you understand what I mean?
Yeah.
And they are not, they don't feel, if a man stands in front of a mirror and looks at himself, he can perhaps feel a little bit ashamed of it, you know. He looks at his clothes and his hair and his face. A woman by education is not ashamed of looking at herself. Do you understand what I mean?
I do, but I wonder, it surprises me, because women are supposed to be more vain, much more concerned with how they look, much more afraid that they'll be seen at a bad angle or in a bad light or...
But that's different. I think that's different.
Ingmar means that it's easier for a woman to camouflage her narcissistic feelings, but for a man it becomes unpleasant immediately. I don't know if that's what you mean, but
yes, it's just that by education. We are a little bit ashamed when we look in the mirror. Women aren't.
Do you ever argue over how a scene should go? Have you ever said to him, "You're just wrong. I'm an actor and I know what's right"?
Yes.
No, I never say that.
You're arguing now.
She always tells me about... it was her quest.
Yeah. Tell me what I tell you.
Can you remember a time when you said...
We argue, yes. Yeah. But I don't call it an argument. I just call it that I'm explaining myself. And maybe I'm doing it in an arguing way, I don't know.
It's nice. I like very much when the actors tell me what they want to do.
But you know what's so good about Ingmar is that he never says to an actor that you are wrong. That's a very common sentence otherwise from directors, that you have misunderstood and you're wrong. Because it's, excuse me for explaining that's how I experience it, that an actor can never be wrong, because what he expresses comes out of him. So even if he misunderstands maybe the whole idea of what Ingmar wants to say, he cannot make a scene wrong because he does it honestly from himself. So therefore, you have to discuss in other ways than you must do it another way. It's not like that. It's more talking psychologically about the person you're playing, and not talking to the actor and changing him, but changing the thoughts about that person you're creating. Am I right?
Yes.
Yeah. And that's much more fun because you don't feel attacked personally. You feel like this is something we're doing apart from ourselves.